Turn it up. What's going on, everyone? Today, you're inside my unfinished garage once again. I got a video coming up really soon about working on this thing. But today, we're going to talk about this. This is a project I've had for way too long now. It actually looks pretty good. It's been in storage for a long time now, so it's not running, which is why we're going to make a few videos about it. This is my 1997 Suzuki TL1000S. So, this bike has a great history behind it. I've known the two previous owners, and these bikes are known for having bad reputations of hurting the riders, hurting their owners, getting people killed. I mean, they're also a lot of fun. So, just a little quick backstory. The guy I got it off of, the person before him, I knew that guy. And the story I heard with it was he had it for a long time. And one day he was riding his bike and on the interstate and lost a back wheel bearing. Completely just shattered on him or something. To where he lost control of the bike and actually hit the side of a semi truck. Like the trailer of the truck, and didn't go down. Somehow kept it up and got off the side of the road and had someone come pick it up in the truck so I could repair that. So, and I think a few months later, he was doing a wheelie or something like that and popped a motor on this thing. So, it got a new engine for it, but the guy was very busy. He never got time to put the motor in, so the bike just sat in his basement for like a year or two. And finally, he gave up on it and decided to sell it. At that time, he offered it to me because I already had another TL1000S at that time. So I would have loved to add two of them. But I didn't have the money for it. So another guy I knew that worked with him actually bought the bike. And I told the guy not to. It was his first bike, but he was really excited. So he went ahead and bought it. And put the motor in, put a bunch of stuff together, and the first day he fired the bike up, there was a fuel leak, and it caught fire. So this bike actually burnt down. I've got a couple pictures. I'll try and put them up as I'm talking. This bike was pretty crispy. So I got it for a really good price off him because there was, honestly, everyone who knew me looked at that bike and said there was no way it could be put back together. It was just done. But I knew what I was looking at. I've worked on these quite a few times. I love these bikes. So I got the bike, brought it home, and been working ever since. And I got to the point where I got it, and I got it running. Was very excited about that. Took it out on a couple kind of test rides and shakedown rides. It's had some problems here or there. So, it's an awesome bike. But it's been in storage for me, too. I kind of had it on a back burner and kind of stuck it off to the side because I was building this huge garage. That way, I wouldn't be working outside anymore. So now, I figured it was time because I got to keep you guys entertained. And because I got to keep you guys entertained, it's keeping me on my toes to work on my stuff, which is awesome. I love it. Thank you for YouTube. It gets you off your butt. So I went ahead and ordered the parts I need to get this back up and running, because when I did get it running, it wasn't really running too well because I was trying not to replace a lot of parts on it. I just wanted to see if it would even run after the fire. But I'm going to get the parts real quick, show you what parts we're going to need to put this back together, at least I think so, unless something has gone bad. So here's the parts, guys. First off, I mean, I'll turn the key on. There's nothing. I let the battery just sit. I didn't start it, so the battery is flat and dead. So I picked up one of these. It's a Chrome Pro battery, I think. Yeah. Really cool battery. Got it on Amazon. I've used these quite a few times on other bikes I've had and never had a problem out of them. I've actually got like a little digital screen on here, and you can push the button, and it'll tell you how many days it's been in the bike. and it'll show you the battery level, and it'll actually push the button again, and it'll show you what the voltage is. So that's pretty cool bike, or pretty cool battery. I highly recommend it. So I've been using them. They're like, I think it was like $30-something for that shipped, so it's not bad. And then when I first got the bike running after the fire, I never changed the plugs. So I had a slight, it was running a little rough after I got it running, but I figured I got some NGK plugs for it. And one part I did not replace, which I really should have, is the coil packs with the plug wires on them. The ones in the bike, which you'll see in another episode, is they're crispy. I should have replaced them. They were burnt, but they were still working. But I think they're not working 100%. So we're going to go ahead, replace them with this used set, but they're in perfect working order, so no problems there. But yeah, so this is my TL1000S. I'm going to do a lot of fun stuff with this, guys. I think you're going to like this one. Let me know, do you guys like this color? It's, well, I can't keep it this. The tank is a little burnt, so can't keep it this color. But I've got a really fun idea I think you guys are going to laugh about that I'm going to do with this. Yeah. But, well, get the camera real quick and we'll do a little walk around the bike so you guys can take a look and see what it actually looks like up close. Okay, guys, so here we are. Do a little walkthrough of the bike. So the guy that used to own the bike, not the previous owner, but the guy before him, he polished the frame, had chrome wheels put on it. He had the bike looking really good. He's a painter too, so the whole bike he did in like a candy apple red. It looked, back in the day, it looked really, really good. And it's a little faded, but it's got dual Yoshimura exhausts, the RS3s, which sound really good on this bike. It's got a nice, what they call, if you're not a bike person, a rear set. The only thing I don't like is those don't fold. On a factory bike, those fold in if you go down. Which, if you look in, you can see it's a little... I had to build a whole new harness, but a lot of the stuff is still crunchy in there. So I'm gonna be doing a lot of work on this thing. Have you guys follow along. And then you can see how the... Yeah, there was some problems. But it's a awesome, awesome bike. I love these things. Especially the 97 models. They're awesome bikes. They have their quirks about them, but what car bike doesn't? This one, I can't turn it on, but it's got I think it's got around 36,000 miles, which sounds like a lot on a bike, but I've never had one of these with under 30-something thousand miles, and I've never had problems out of them. Now, I have told you that this bike right here basically tried to kill the two previous owners. The previous owner, he started up and it burst into flames on him in his garage. He told me it took him almost 10 minutes to put the fire out. He rolled it out of the garage, threw the bike on the ground, sprayed it with a hose. It was bad. And I already told you about the previous owner before him on the interstate. Well, the two or three times I have ridden this thing, it has each time done something to me. So you can see that crack in the windshield. Well, the first test ride on this thing, I had all the body panels on. Apparently, I didn't have the windshield on that good. It was just some temporary bolts, which were still there. The windshield came loose and smacked me right in the face and flew away. It was bad. It didn't hurt me at all. I was just laughing. I had to turn around and go pick it up and carry on back home. But then I did have this thing leaving my house. Luckily, I was just at my house pulling out. And I was going, I mean, I wasn't even going that fast, and went and turned a corner and the steering locked. And this thing high-sided me right off the bike. So, but that's it, guys. That is my TL1000S. I do need your help. Yes, I really do need your help, guys. So, you've met the bike, you know I name all my projects, so you've met Stuart Little, the Miata, and you're going to meet more and more of my other projects. I have names for one of them, but I don't have a name for that. I need your help with that. So someone, put in the comments, what do you guys think I should call it? The only thing I could come up with is it caught fire on the previous owner, so I wanted to call the bike Flashpoint. So figured it was red, which is not going to stay red. I'm not telling you guys what I'm going to do with it later on, but we're going to just get it running and just test a few things, and then we're going to start having a lot of fun. You're going to laugh a lot about this, but help me come up with a name. If you're not a subscriber yet and you're liking this video and you like what you're going to come and see later on, subscribe to the channel now. Help me grow my channel. Let's see what we can do with this thing. So till next time, guys, I got too many projects and I got more coming. So see you later. Thanks for watching.